Valley News Live, the Valley Skycam showing that beautiful setting sun out to the west. Tonight is Luther Family Ford Weather Kid Night, and I have a dandy to introduce you to. It's Hallie Nicholas coming to us from Crookston, right? That's a long bicycle ride on a cold day. All right, what grade are you in, Hallie?
Fourth grade.
Okay, how old are you?
Nine.
You're nine. Okay, good. And then what's your favorite subject at school?
Reading.
Reading is a good one. I like reading too. And anybody you want to say hi to real quick before we talk about this weather?
Mrs. Heppner's class.
Mrs. Heppner's class. Give them all a wave out there and step over here. And I want you to tell everybody out at home tonight in Fargo what the current conditions are. What's the temperature?
It's 12 degrees.
Good. How fast is the wind blowing right now?
Northeast, 3 miles per hour.
Very good. We have pretty clear skies, just a few clouds off to the west. Now, in Grand Forks, it looks very similar. A little bit more snowpack on the ground up north, isn't there? Was there more snow in Crookston, too? Okay, tell everybody the temperature in Grand Forks right now.
It's 4 degrees and it feels like 8.
Yeah, and there's a minus in front of that 8, so you know what
Negative.
We call that? Yeah, cold. That's really cold out there, a 7-mile-per-hour wind. So a jacket or maybe shorts and a t-shirt tonight?
Jacket.
Jacket, definitely. Point out the coldest temperature you see in North Dakota right now.
Langdon is -4.
Yeah, they have the only minus sign sticking out. That they kind of stick out like a sore thumb, and it's 12 in Gwinner. Let's walk over here and take a look across Minnesota. Pick out any town and point out their temperature.
Bemidji, it's 6 degrees.
Very good. Yeah, so temperatures are in the single digits above and below zero up to around 10, and that's all we got, folks. And here is a look at the satellite and radar right now. And when you look across the region, do you see a lot of clouds in our area?
Yeah.
Yeah, and they're coming at us from the west. Over us right now, though, we're enjoying crystal clear skies. And clear skies mean we're going to cool off pretty quickly early this evening. Here's your forecast now. There's the white stuff. What's that again?
Clouds.
Clouds. And they're going to move this way as we head through the evening. But tell us what the temperatures will be like by 10. Does it look bitter cold or warmer?
Cold.
Yeah, it's going to be chilly. Light winds this evening. That's one of the nice things about the weather this evening. Now, when we head to bed, or if you're up really, really late overnight, where do the clouds move?
The clouds move north.
Yeah, right over the top of us. So when we rise and shine on Friday morning, it looks like everyone has a chance of cloudy skies. Does it look like everyone has a chance of snow?
No.
Why don't you inspect this? Tell us where you see some snow on there.
Canada.
Up way in Canada. Temperatures, look at that. They warm up overnight. Isn't that wild? So no sun out, but our temperatures warm up because the wind becomes southerly, and it's going to gust to that speed. What speed is that?
16 miles per hour.
Yeah, and we'll have gusts over 20 miles per hour. So it's going to be windy and cold, and wind chills could be as cold as 20 below first thing in the morning. Lunch hour, does it look sunny or cloudy for most areas?
Cloudy.
Cloudy skies and very gusty winds, almost 30 miles per hour. But those winds from the south will bring warmer air our way. Now, when this happens, sometimes we get a few flurries of snow. What areas might see a little bit of snow tomorrow afternoon?
Fargo and Devil's Lake and Grand Forks.
Yeah, these areas right here where we see the blues, but it's not for everybody, so just hit and miss flakes of snow. How about temperatures? Do they look warmer than today or
warmer?
Colder? Yeah, a big warm-up in store, but it comes with some wind, and that warming trend even continues into the evening. So we'll have a chance for some scattered snow showers across parts of western Minnesota, but windy and warmer tomorrow is the story. In Fargo, the temperature starts at 12, and what's the warmest we get?
31 degrees.
Yeah, and we'll follow it down here and see what time that is.
4 p.m.
And what time do you get out of school?
3.
Okay, so it'll be warming up after school, and that's not too bad. Here's the bus stop forecast for Crookston. Why don't you take this away, Hallie? Tell everybody what they can expect.
13 degrees, south-southeast wind, 18 miles per hour.
Okay, so definitely 1 or 10 pumps of hairspray?
10
pumps of hairspray, and after school forecast, what's it look like?
26 degrees and 19 miles per hour.
Very good. And it looks like it's going to continue to be windy right into the evening hours. Hometown forecast shows that the warmest air will be southwest of Fargo, and the coldest air will be out to the north and east where we'll have some teens. Do you know what these are called, Hallie, by the way?
Northern Lights.
Very good. Give me 5. That's outstanding. A great shot by Casey from Valley City. These were just a couple of nights ago, the lights dancing in the sky. Okay, Saturday's forecast, which is Veterans Day. Does it look warmer or colder?
warmer.
And there's a 30% chance of a few flakes, but it doesn't look like a big storm. As we head into Sunday, we'll stay in the 30s, but how about next week? What do the temperatures look like?
In the 40s.
In the 40s?
Low 40s.
Yeah, it looks pretty good compared to what we've had lately. So a warmer forecast. The next best chance of snow, though, and rain comes on Thursday. Hallie, nice job. Follow me over here. I got to tell you, I am really a big fan of seeing some 40s in there because it seems like a long, long time since we've had them. How about you? What's your favorite kind of weather?
Fall weather.
Fall weather. We had about, I don't know, 3 days of fall this year, so I'm glad you enjoyed
about it.
That.
Yeah.
All right. Nice job.
Great job.